Hello guys, welcome back to the TenorShare channel. Many people are switching from WhatsApp or Telegram to Signal recently. They are migrating because of Signal's unwavering dedication to user privacy and data security. Endorsements from Elon Musk and Edward Snowden just convinced more people of that. The surge of user signups even overwhelmed their server and prompted an outage for hours. Fortunately, they have restored their service and everything is going well now. So, now that you are a Signal user, you might be wondering, beyond the end-to-end encryption which already applied to every message, is there anything I can do to make it even more secure? Definitely yes, there are also some customizable settings for you to tweak it a little. In this video I'll walk you through each of them. Let's dive in. To make a comparison, I installed Signal on my Android phone and signed up with another phone number. First, I'd like to show you how to tweak the privacy settings. So I tap on my profile name on my iPhone, then privacy. The first one is read receipts. With it enabled, the check mark under each message would turn from blank to filled to tell your friend that you have read the messages. With it off, it'll stay blank on the other end even after you read it. Moving on, the next one is typing indicator. When it's on, your friends will know that you are typing when they see the rippling dots here. Toggling it off, then nothing shows up other the other end. See, this is how peaceful communicating with each other could be. Next one, generate preview links. Turning it on. Preview comes with the link. Disabling it. Simply a link. Moving on, what exactly does this registration lock do? Let's find out. With this on, anyone seemed to be able to log us out simply with our phone number. With it on. They'll need the PI and code to proceed. To boost it even more, let's see how the screen lock works. So I enable it on my iPhone, but keep it off on my Android. Then go ahead and close both of them. Now let's check it out. See, the Android version allows me directly access to it with a simple tap, while the iOS version asking me for the passcode. This is useful when your friends want to try your phone and you don't want them to see the chats. Moving on, with screen security disabled on Android, Signal previews appear in the app switcher. With it enabled on iPhone, just a logo there for anyone to see. There are also some other options, like display indicator and allow from anyone. I suggest you to keep them off. You can also clear chat history here if you want. In notification settings, you can customize how much details you want to preview. With content and name. Name only. Or just tell you there's a new message. Of course, you can turn off notification completely in iOS settings if you want. In addition to these, Signal offers some chat settings here for individual contacts, such as disappearing messages, so let's toggle it on. Schedule it to 5 seconds. Now let's give it a shot. See, the messages have disappeared on both devices. You can also mute message sound for specific people like this. If you also own an iPad, it'd be a good idea for you to link it with your phone. Both iPhone and Android are supported. Why should we do that? Because it virtually creates another backup of our account and chats. So we get Signal on the iPad from App Store. Then go ahead and add it as a new device. When the QR code shows up, tap your profile name on your iPhone, then head to Link Devices, tap Link New Device and scan the QR code. Choose a name for your iPad. Then here we go. All the chats and contacts have been literally duplicated to the iPad. which is awesome since you can also chat with your friends the same as using an iPhone. That's it. Thanks for watching. I hope this video helps your guys. Have a nice day. See you in the next video.